15 years ago, on January 21st, 2003, Into the Wild was released. Warrior Cats is 15 years old today, or the day this video was uploaded. Anyways, to celebrate, I will be counting down the 15 cats that I enjoyed the most over the 15 years of books in about 15 minutes. So, this list will be entirely my opinion. Here are the four main reasons I enjoy a character. The character is easy to root for and develop to the point in which I care about their well-being. The character represents some ideal, such as kindness, hard work, etc. Essentially, the character acts as a role model and you can learn from their mistakes. The character is unique, standing out from the hundreds of others in the series. And finally, the character is relevant to the story and helps with the progression and delivery of whatever message the author is trying to convey. So, those are my reasons. I think it's about time we get started. Number 15. Dovewing. Okay, I understand that a lot of people hate Dovewing because she's apparently a Mary Sue and unfairly replaced Hollyleaf and whatever. But I believe that Dovewing was actually a very necessary addition to the Omen of the Stars books. We needed this new perspective. As for her development, yes, it was lacking compared to Ivypool and Jayfeather. And yes, the Tigerheart romance wasn't interesting before the Super Edition. However, I find Dovewing very helpful in establishing the personality and goals of Ivypool, giving Lionblaze something to be responsible for, and of course, adding a unique way of storytelling using her extended senses. Also, Dovewing's novella had a nice message. Number 14. Misty Star. The reasons I like Misty Star are very simple. She had a lot of charm in the original series, and the fact that she was Blue Star's kit was very interesting. Especially that early on in the series. She also had a novella, and while it was more about Mothwing, I enjoy that it gave Misty Star a small amount of development. Number 13. Daisy. So, Daisy is probably the most hated character I'm putting on this list. But please, hear me out. Daisy is such a wholesome character. She really helps establish ThunderClan as a community. She overcomes her fears about the dangers of clan life in order to contribute to it in a big way. I can really respect the care she puts into ThunderClan. Number 12. Crooked Star. I really enjoy all the questions posed by the Crooked Star's Promise Super Edition. Sure, it was needlessly depressing at times. But from reading about Crooked Star having to deal with his mother's negligence, or just Mapleshade, we get some great internal conflict. Once he recovers from his broken jaw, his main struggles aren't threatening his life or the existence of his clan. They're on the inside. Isn't that deep? I don't know why I'm still whispering. But seriously, the writing team did a really good job of fleshing out an entire story from a simple design quirk. Number 11. Brightheart. Something about Brightheart's injury just makes her so appealing as a character. It's hard not to love the cats who faced hardships and overcame them. Also, the relationship she shares with Cloudtail while she is recovering has to be among the cutest in the entire series. She is just such an underdog, and I love her for it. Wait, underdog? Should it be Undercat? Number 10. Brackenfur. Personally, I think Brackenfur is overrated. He hardly did anything in the books, and yet people praise him for having such a sad and meaningful life because they saw that one PMV. However, before you all get mad at me for disrespecting Brackenfur, I too am one of those people praising him. He is an amazing example of a character that is developed by reading in between the lines. If you really take into account every single mention of Brackenfur, you really feel for him. Piecing together the story of minor characters is sort of a reward for reading every book. Brackenfur is amazing. Number 9. Shrewtooth. Alright, I'll admit, this is pretty high on the list for such a random cat, but I can't help but adore Shrewtooth. He only plays a somewhat major role in one book in the series, SkyClan's Destiny, but he nails that role. In the book, he is introduced as a random cat SkyClan took in who happens to be afraid of everything. I won't spoil why, but his character development is definitely my favorite thing about this Super Edition. Leafstar caring for him is just so heartwarming. Also, when the book ends, we see him change to be braver than we anticipated, and the result is a very satisfying character arc. Unfortunately, he randomly disappears from SkyClan between books, but he was a great character while he lasted. Number 8. Tiger Star. Something that really disappoints me about much of the Warriors series is just how weak some of the villains are, especially Soul. Part of this disappointment comes from the fact that they fail to live up to the example of Tiger Star. Tiger Star is just pure evil, and he sets up conflict perfectly in the original books. He gives Firestar a reason to take all the risks that he did. You can really feel Firestar's genuine fear of Tiger Star. Tiger Star's rise to power was very well executed in terms of building suspense, and Firestar overcoming the challenges set up by Tiger Star was unbelievably satisfying. Number 7. Firestar. What would this list be without the cat that started it all? He is also the only protagonist character with 7 books all to himself. Actually, he would also be the only protagonist with more than one book to himself. Like him or not, Firestar is the character that got most of us into the series. He is simply every definition of the word hero. Even when comparing him to other protagonists, Firestar stands out. First, because it's very cool seeing him grow from kitty pet to leader over 6 books. Also, he is quite the risk taker, which makes the books all the more interesting, because you get to question his choices and be curious about their outcomes. While it is a little disappointing to see his personality fade when he is removed from the spotlight, it was amazing while it lasted, and it was amazing that it lasted for as long as it did. Number 6. Hollyleaf. Yeah, I love black cats, and for how common they are, Warriors severely underrepresents them in favor of having 2 billion gray or ginger characters. I was really excited for Hollyleaf. Then she sort of disappointed. She had little relevance for most of Power of 3, and when she finally got the spotlight in Sunrise, her emotions were very poorly written and all around unconvincing. But wait, this is a top 15 list. What I actually did like about Hollyleaf was her return. The problem with Omen of the Stars is that a lot of it is just filler that only exists for the sake of dragging out the Dark Forest story long enough to fill up 6 books. Hollyleaf came in and stopped what could possibly have been the most boring book in the entire series. It's really hard not to respect her after all she went through and how much she grew. It was also really nice that we got a novella diving deep into her emotions. It really helps you feel for her in a way that Sunrise failed to do. All around, she's just a really cool cat with a really cool story. Number 5. Jayfeather. There is a reason Jayfeather is a fan favorite. He basically carries the story from the site all the way to the last hope. And he is such an amazing perspective to read from. His blindness allows for so many sensory details outside of sight to be explored. Also, his ability to read emotions was something really new and interesting. Oh, and his other powers? Well, they were simply fun to read about. At the points where Power of Three was trying to be a mystery novel, Jay Feather was a very cool detective. Also, the fact that he got to be a protagonist in both Power of Three and Omen of the Stars really gave him time to have some great development. We saw Jay Feather grow from a whiny kit to a whiny full-grown cat, I guess. Still a great character, though. Number 4. Tall Star. Best Super Edition, hands down. I find most of the Warrior Super Editions to be either pointlessly depressing or just plain boring. For Tall Star, the writing team actually put forward a story with some great messages tucked in. It's hard not to respect Tall Star. It really is. From him, we learn about revenge, kindness, and forgiveness. Also, it's nice to have a break from the romance-driven plots in order to have a greater focus on family. The best part about Tall Star is that when he faced tragedy and desired revenge, he was actually able to learn that his line of thinking was wrong and grow from it. His story is Maple Shade done right. Number 3. Clear Sky. Out of all the villains in Warrior Cats, Clear Sky is by far my favorite. We actually get his perspective at the same time as Greywing, the hero, and it really makes the first battle really interesting because we learn about the motives of both sides. From Clear Sky, we learn how personal perception can give false justifications for actions. Also, we see reasons for why Greywing, the hero, can be perceived as a villain from another perspective. After the first battle, Clear Sky's redemption arc really puts a fantastic twist on the role villains normally have in Warrior Cats. We get to explore some actual feelings of regret and self-doubt from Clear Sky. All around, I really enjoyed seeing Clear Sky react to the many challenges he faced and the changes he made accordingly. Number 2. Ivy Pool. I just want to take a moment to bring attention to how cool Ivy Pool is. An actual prophecy foretold of 4 very specific cats that would save the clans from the darkness and such. 4 cats with special powers. Yet, Ivy Pool, despite not being one of those cats, arguably did more to stop the Dark Forest than 3 of the cats that were in the prophecy. Like, Dovewing, your powers may have been useful in alerting the clans a few hours before the Dark Forest arrived, but Ivy Pool, she knew everything moons in advance. Also, major respect for her being brave enough to spy on Dark Forest cats who could totally kill her easily. She's just the most fun character to root for in the entire series. She grew from an insecure kit to a courageous beast. Number 1. Gray Strike Wing. I just like Dawn of the Clans, okay? So, part of what makes Greywing so enjoyable is the fact that he has no idea what his purpose in life is. He's no prophecy cat, he's not going to be a medicine cat, he's not going to lead a clan. He is just a cat. Without a destiny or an obvious plot direction hanging over his head, I could really get interested in the changes he went through during his life. His struggle to find a direction in his life can be very relatable and interesting to read about. The amount of mistakes he made created a very realistic feel for him. The fact that he didn't have an obvious choice for a mate, and the fact that his brief leadership was very informal, built upon that. Also, I feel like the amount of tragedy he faced was just enough. All around, Greywing has a very solid storyline, and that is why he is my favorite cat. So, at this point, you're probably wondering, hey, where's Cinderpelt? Where's Yellowfang? Where's Blue Star? If you are, just know that while I personally don't enjoy these characters as much as many of you, they all still have likable aspects to them. Feel free to post in the comments some of the characters that would be on your top 15 list.